Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're gonna be showing you my personal favorite way to create a cinematic black bar opening effect. So let's just slow it down for a second and show you what this effect actually looks like. This effect can really help to draw in your audience by slowly revealing whatever's behind the black bars. You can see how this makes your footage a lot more interesting. That previous example that we just showed was just two shots, but slowly revealing what was actually behind the black bars helped to build the anticipation a little bit. And it can be really effective if you have really cool shots that have something that you can isolate in that center of frame. The best part of all this is that it's a really easy effect to pull off, and you can do it all in Premiere Pro. And we're gonna do it all in under 5 minutes. So let's jump into it. The first thing that we're going to do is drop our footage onto our timeline. Now, the way we're actually going to go about this effect is to create a new layer that holds the black bars, and we're literally going to be peering through them as they open up. It's going to be like we're making a slit that gradually opens up more and more. So to start, create a new graphics layer by going to the Essential Graphics panel and hitting the page icon here and selecting Rectangle. And you can see that it pops up a new layer on our timeline. Let's just stretch it out over the entire duration of our footage. This is what we're gonna use to create the black of our black bars from, and we're gonna stretch it out over our entire frame. It doesn't have to be clean or precise. You can also go down here to the zoom level and choose something wider, like 25%, just to make sure that you can see your entire frame. And now let's go to our color swatch here under Essential Graphics, or it's also under the Effects Controls window, and we're gonna choose Perfect Black to be our color. Great! Make sure that Stroke and Shadow are off while you're at it. Cool! We've stretched it out here, and now comes the fun part, making the slit. Now, Premiere is not as versatile a program as After Effects, for example, for having grids and centering tools and making your graphics really precise. So, the closer you follow here to my instructions, the better your results will be. Go up to your effects controls, and let's go underneath the shape section here that we just created. And we're gonna choose to create a rectangular mask from it. Click it, but don't touch the mask. Why shouldn't we touch it? Well, because right now it's perfectly centered, and we don't wanna have to try and finesse it back to the center. It's just easier if we do the following. Make sure that your selection tool is highlighted, and then that our shape layer is highlighted. Now, we're gonna be highlighting the mask in effects controls, and then click and drag over these two points of the rectangle. Now that they're highlighted, click either one of them and hold the shift button and then drag them out way past the edge of your frame. Holding shift is important because it makes sure that you're only moving across from left to right and not up and down. This will keep all the vertical centering exactly the same. Cool, so we're just gonna go ahead and repeat it for the other side. Awesome! So this may be hard to understand why we're actually going through all this trouble, but I guarantee it'll make things a lot easier for us in just a second. Let's go down here to the inverted button and select it. Ah, now you can see what we're going for. But it's a little bit fuzzy because my default edge feather is set for 10. Let's just set it to 0 so that we get a nice crisp edge. And guys, you've just created your black bars. So the question is now, how do we make them open and close? Well, that's the best part because everything is perfectly centered, and we've extended our shape of the mask all the way past the edge of the frame. So we can just use the mask expansion underneath our mask settings in effect controls to control how open or how closed our black bars are. Awesome, right? And because moving it from open to closed is so easy, animating it is going to be even easier. So if we go from the beginning of our clip and drag it all the way down so that it's closed, and then we set a keyframe for mask expansion, then we go forwards and keyframe it, we can see that we've just told our black bars to open up. Nice! And if we wanted it to come to a nice slow stop, let's just go to the second keyframe, right click it, and add an ease in. Now it comes to a smooth stop. And if we want to make the effect happen faster, let's just drag the last keyframe in. And if we wanted to make it super long and dramatic, we just have to drag this keyframe way back. Simple as that. And because this is all being controlled by a layer isolated away from any of your footage, you can have one clip or a whole sequence of clips underneath your black bars as they open up. And the effect itself doesn't change. This also gives you the added benefit of being able to move around your footage underneath so that you can choose what actually ends up in the center of the slit. Play around with it and see how you can integrate it into your next video. And if you wanted to take this effect to the next level, as always, adding sound effects and ambience can really help to sell your footage. And for your convenience, I've listed all of the motion ray sound effects and ambience that I used in the beginning intro sequence example. Adding sound effects is a huge part of selling an effect, and if you want to see that in another application, check out our video that we did on speed ramping your footage. Using speed ramping during your cinematic opening that we just learned how to do might be a really cool combination. But guys, that's it for me. If you liked this video, give it a like. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to keep up to date with everything that we do. And just as a gift for those of you who watch here on YouTube, as always, we have a discount code in the description below to get 20% off your first month subscription at Motion Array. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.